When it first happened, we came out with temporary traffic control just to control the intersection and keep people from going in. Since then, we've had our signing crews have come in and put semi-permanent signs up marking the detour.
We've installed over 100 signs.
About every 10 miles, there's another sign that says keep going. And we've got some message boards at all the places to make a decision on which way to turn.
We found out there was a storm coming through, rain up in this area on the site, along with snow accumulations of up to an inch. We did have a contractor mob in rather quickly. And so what his mission was to dig a trench on the east side of the road.
Contractor showed up, moved a bunch of boulders and debris that was in the way. Rough graded a construction access road around the damaged site and put down thick plastic liner so that water would run off the site and protect the site from water infiltration.
We have crevices in the earth over 30 feet deep, and the desire is not to have moisture in those areas because when the moisture gets down into the earth, it gives it a higher chance of sliding even farther.
The core drill, it will give us a continuous core sample.
Now we're looking at maybe this is sand filling in a joint.
We'll see it as it comes out of the ground. So hopefully we can detect shears that are developed. They could be within the hard rock. They could be within the Chinle clay that's underneath.
This will tell us how fractured this entire mass is and ideally where the slide plane is at, so that we can figure out how far do we need to go to remediate the slide or what some of our options are.
It's called an inclineometer. This seems pretty basic, but it's actually pretty sophisticated. There's grooves in the inclineometer pipe, and these runners just run down the grooves. And as it goes down, if it starts turning, either way, it measures that angle.
That is then uploaded into software on a computer, and you get a graph, basically, that spits out the deflections that are in the ground. And so it can give us readings several hundred feet down. In this case, we're trying to go down about 150 feet. We think that the shears in the bedrock are probably at least, say, 100 to 120 feet deep. It's a very deep slide.
There was some sort of geological event that occurred, obviously, up here. And so we just can't come up here and replace the road for the sake of replacing it. We need to determine what the cause was in order to best use our funds to reestablish the route.
ADOT, keeping Arizona moving.